Greetings to all. Welcome to the channel Simtech05. In this playlist, we will learn Abacus basics. Even if you never used the Abacus software, you can start watching this series, this playlist, and you will be familiar with the Abacus software. So, this is the first video, and today we will see some introduction of the Abacus, GUI, and basic part creation and meshing. So this is my Abacus version name. Here we have main menu, and these all are the toolbars. Apart from here also we have some tools, but those are not toolbars. Those tools depend on the module. In the bottom side also we have some toolbars. This is our feature tree. Whatever options we have in the main menu or in the toolbar can be accessed from the feature tree also. Feature tree also tell us the history of finite element model, like how much number of parts you have, what material you have, what profile and sections you have, what number of component you have in the assembly, sets, groups, connectors and so on. Of course, contact force and amplitudes also. Here, this blue screen is our GUI workspace in which our model will be visible. And the last, this bottom panel is nothing but your message area, or sometime we can say command line interface. Here you will get the messages also, or you can feed some inputs through the command line. Now some more basic points. If you want to change the background color of the workspace, you can change by main menu, view, graphic options, and you can change color here. If you want a gradient color, keep it on gradient options. Otherwise you can use the solid. Here the solid black color is chosen and the screen become black. And if you want to change something different, like I want to choose the white color, make sure this cursor exactly on the white. Now click on OK, apply. So now the workspace background color is white. I will let you know the other options also in future videos, but here the solid options only important. So if you want to keep the default setting, just click on default, apply and OK. Let me quickly create one part because I want to tell you zooming, rotating and other options. Default mouse configuration of the Abacus for rotating, moving and pan the component or assembly, such like that. Control, Alt and mouse button first. This is for rotation. You have to press and hold Control, Alt button, then MB1 mouse button first, or you can say left hand side mouse button. To pan it, again you have to press Ctrl, Alt and MB2. Likewise, mouse button 2. You have to press and hold mouse button 2. And to zoom in and zoom out, Ctrl, Alt and you can roll the mouse button. So the component will be zoom out and zoom in. If you press only control button and then roll the mouse button 2, it will zoom out and zoom in fastly. But many times it happens if someone is HyperWorks user or CATIA user and suddenly he started working on Abacus, he started learning Abacus, he faced lots of difficulty in the mouse configuration. So if you want to change this configuration of the mouse, you can go with tool, options, view manipulation, Abacus. So here you can see the keywords for the pan, rotate and zoom. You can change it with CATIA V5. See, the same button, those are dedicated to CATIA, can be used for rotate, pan and move the component likewise. Similarly, again go to the tool, options, Hyperbox. Click on OK. Now, the Hyperbox button, Ctrl MB1, Ctrl MB2, and Ctrl MB3 will work. See? So, I advise to use this manipulation key as per your requirement initially, but once you are familiar little bit with the software, you have to switch again to the Abacus CAUI, because few of the selection and deselection options will work properly in Abacus CAE application. So I am going to keep Abacus CAE application. One more thing here, the icon. If you are not satisfied with the icon size, you can change the icon size by some value, by some scale factor, and click on OK. And you must note that restart is required to apply the scale factor. So I'm not going to change. I'm going to cancel it. Tool options, manipulation, not hyperview, Abacus CAE, control keys. Okay, now it's fine. I'm going to delete my existing part because I want to make part again. So right click and delete. Yes. So in Abacus, all things are arranged in form of module. Like you have part module, then property. In part module, we can create part, edit part. In property, we have to assign the material, we have to define the material, cross-sectional property, material calibration, and those all things we can define. Then in assembly module, we have to assemble number of parts, like we have 5 part, we have 4 part, or we have assembly of 50 parts. We have to assemble those by using this assembly tool. You may see in the similar type of options in the CAD software also, like rotate and then translate, and we have some constraints here. Okay. After that, I have to define the step. The step is nothing, the type of analysis that you want to perform, and for what amount of time you want to perform it. Of course, some analysis are time independent, there we not need any time. Interactions are nothing but contacts and connection. Like you have assembly of the components. For the assembly of component, two component may be in the contact, may they rigidly fix, or may they are sliding over each other. So these type of things, these type of action between number of components we have to define using interaction options. In interaction, we have lots of, not only in the interaction, in each module we have lots of, more than I explained right now. But initially, the basic point you have to understand, the load. In the load module, you have to define the boundary conditions and forces. Forces like pressure, momentum, point load, distributed load, so on. The next module is massing module. If you are hypermesh user or ANSA user, you may see after creation of part, we start massing, then we apply the loading and boundary condition. But in Abacus, you can apply load, boundary condition, material property to the geometry itself. Then later you need to mass it, and the loading will be automatically transferred to the element and node. So do not worry about that. Even you can mass first, then go for assigning property, defining step and boundary condition, connections, so on. Optimization is for optimize the component in such a way that we want to reduce the material, we want to increase the stiffness, we want to change the frequency of the component by modifying its original geometry, and so on. Job is nothing but whatever model you prepared, accordingly you want to create a job with proper name. Like first I created a simulation for 1 second, static simulation for 1 second. So I can define a name, job name, static 1 second. Then I want to rerun the simulation for the 2 second. So I have to change few parameter in the step module, then I can create one more job and define the name static 2 second and so on. Once you complete the job, you have to go for visualization for the visualizing results for the post processing. So these are the modules, and last one is sketch. So no need to explain this sketch individually, because in the part modeling itself you have to utilize the sketch options. So go to the part modeling, you can create here on this icon, create part, and the part modeling window will be available to you. Or you can double click on the part, make sure you expand this model, and then double click on that part. Again, this part window will be available to you. You can also go with this manager, part manager. In part manager, like if you have number of part, 5 part, 4 part, the list will be visible here. So I always recommend to prefer the managers. Here we have part manager. Go to the create part one, say cylinder. I want to create. d deformable and solid extrusion I want. You can go with the revolution, sweep, and any other options. So very easily you can detect we are creating a 3D deformable solid extrusion part. Here we have lots of options. One by one we will see in the future videos. The most important part is approximate size. This is nothing but your canvas size. Like you want to make a painting and you want a canvas of size 200. Similarly, we want to make a sketch, and for that I want a canvas size of 200. So what is that 200? Meter, millimeter, centimeter, what? See, Abacus is unitless. Or better to say, in Abacus CA software, you have to keep consistency in the unit. If you are considering this as mm, so in the material also you have to define property by considering length unit in mm. So we will see that also. Go to the continue. You can dismiss it now. Go to the create part. Like you have basic features. I believe all of you very well aware to these features. Some of important I will tell. So circle options. Like you can create circle by choosing the center point through the mouse, and similarly radius you can choose. Another thing that you can do for the particular command, you have to read this. Pick a center point. So what is my center point? Say 0, 0. This is my center point. So software define the center point. Look, the center point is defined. Now it is asking for perimeter point. So the perimeter point, let's say 20, 0. So in x it is 20, in y it is 0. So in this way also you can assign parameters to geometry. Similarly for the rectangle, it is asking for xy, let's say 0, 0. Make sure the comma, then the second point 5, 6. So this will be our circle. So in x it is 5, in y it is 6. And if you want to delete any geometry, here you have delete options. Then you have to select the particular feature that you want to delete by pressing mouse button first, MB1, and click on done. So this geometry will be deleted. Similarly, you can select multiple geometry by press and hold shift button. So by pressing and holding shift button, you can select multiple entities. Okay, this selection will work if you are using default Abacus mouse manipulation command. If you are using different manipulation command for the mouse like Katia keys or HyperVox key, the selection method also will be different for there, for them. So select and delete. If you want to deselect any of entity, press control button and again select the entity. This entity will be deselect. Likewise, if you want to select all entities, press shift and drag the mouse button in such a way that a window will be created. And again, if you want to deselect one entity, press control button and mouse button first, likewise. Okay, how I deleted? See, I not even go to the delete, I not even click on done button, but still I am able to delete. How? By pressing mouse button 2, the roll button that you have to press. Once you press this button, the done will be considered by the software. Okay, similarly, like for rectangle, first point, second point, and say you want to define the dimensions, go to the add dimension and define these dimension. This is 17.5 something, you want to define 20. So press enter button from keyboard or mouse button 2. This dimension say 30, or you can hit enter button. So as we are in the extrude options, we must need a closed loop. I'm not going to create two bodies, so I'm deleting this. And again done, you can click on done button or press mouse button. So now it will ask me for the extrusion height. So my extrusion height is 60. Then we have twisting options and drafting angle, same like CAD software, but I don't want any twisting and drafting. Click on OK. So this is basic of part modeling. So let's create a complicated part. I'm going to delete this cylinder. Say poke off universal joint, 3D deformable solid extrusion. We want the extrusion, not the revolution, and see. If you want the revolution, go to the revolution, similarly put the shape. Okay, continue. One more important thing that I want to explain here is construction line. So if you want to define any moderate or complex sketches, you have to go with first construction line. Define the center point. Always after selecting the command, look here. What it is asking for? A center point or starting point of the construction line. So 0, 0, this is my construction line starting point. And second point I can define anywhere in the x direction, so that point may be 1, 0. So this construction line in x direction defined. Similarly, in the y direction I want to define 0, 0 and 0, 1. So why we are going to create this construction line? Because they will help to define the dimensions properly. Like I want to create a circle, and let's say distance from the x-axis is 20. Oops, what happened? This axis itself moved. So what we have to do after creating the construction lines, you have to make them fix. So to make them fix, what we have here, add construction option. Sorry. Add constraint options. So in the constraints you have fix options. Let them fix, select likewise, shift MB1, press done button or mouse button 2. Now they will be fixed, they will not move from their position to anywhere. Now define the distance of 20, let's say, I'm sorry, not this 20 and minus icon, 20, enter, likewise. So let me create the geometry that I want to create. Say 0, I have this type of geometry. One more circle I want to create from here to here, and few parts I want to trim. So how to trim? Just go to the trim, find the trim. See, these are the creation options. Then here we have free translation, rotation, pattern, and trim options. Here again we have dimension and geometric constraints, and here we have undo, redo, delete options, select options, and few settings parameter. So splitting these things, I want to split, that's fine. And you can go to create one more line likewise, or I can mirror also. Define the parameters. This circle radius 15, fine. This circle radius 10, fine. This distance 5, okay. This one also 5. This would be around 30. This would be around 30. This distance 10, okay. This distance also 10, okay. So now this geometry is in, this sketch is in green color, that's in fully constrained sketch. Say done and define the depth of 20. The second geometry I want to create here, actually I want to create a cylinder that attached to the surface. So how I can create? First I have to create one plane here. So for creating plane, see, these are the geometric creation and modification. Here we have feature suppression or deleting options. Here we have modification options. And here we have again point. These are the datums. See, this is point, this is axis, this is plane. If you press and hold this button, this icon, you will get the options. Say, I want to create an offset datum. Offset from where? Offset from which location? Offset maybe from this location. Enter the value or specify one point. I am going to enter value in which direction? In this direction? No, I want to define the plane in opposite direction. So flip it. Okay, and then define the distance. So this distance was 30, then 15. This is 45. I want to define around 60. Okay, and here I want to create a sketch. So if you go to create again the part, what will happen? One more part will be created. The feature will not add in the current part. And what we want to add a feature in the current part. So do not create a new part, instead create a feature using extrude or whatever you want. I want to create extrude. I want to create extrude on this plane. It is asking for the axis, any of axis you can select. So this I want to define as my axis, and this is my center point. Of course you can go to create a construction line first, but I already explained. Go to define, the dimension 5 is okay. And if you want to make it fully constrained, define distance from the edges. So for that you have to project first, right? Project, what you want to project? I want to project this edge, which one? This one, as well as this one. Click on done. So see, these edges are projected. Go to the plane view. This is the plane view, sketch view actually. Make sure the distance, say 15, yeah. Similarly, you can project these edges also and go with the dimension. Click on done and done. See, one error message is there. Why this error message? Because you want to create an extrude and you must need a closed loop of the geometry, not an open loop. Where it is open, these cross points are representing open loop. Okay, means whatever geometry we projected in this sketch, those are the open geometries. So you can delete it or you can make them as a construction line. Select this line and click on done. Now your geometry is closed. Reverse the direction instead of blind up to face. and this is my face, and click on OK. Now it is asking for face, so select this face and that's OK. So very cool. This type of features you can create within the Abacus itself very easily. This component is visualized in the prospective view, and these are the prospective and parallel view. So if you want to make the parallel view, just go with this options. Now it is in parallel view. So that's all for this video. In second video, we will learn how to mesh this component. So these videos, actually this whole playlist is for the basic, or we can say new users of the Abacus. Stay with this playlist, you will able to learn Abacus software very easily. Thank you. If you want to join my Facebook and Telegram community, the link is available in the video description. You are most welcome to join.